Our scout ship has returned!
Show them how Ifrid's crew can sail!
Okay, Fi. I need you to find us our next Earth Pulse point.
I found one, but it's really, really far. Way up in the northeast.
If it's that far out, it has to be in Engand.
Engand is a collection of small islands. There's a comparatively bigger one called Lionel Island, but that's the exception.
Yeah, I think the Earth Pulse point's probably out there.
Engand, huh? Those waters are haunted by ghost ships, you know.
Ghost ships?
Yep. Legend has it they snatch up wrongdoers who bear lingering regrets and whisk them away to that eternal voyage.
That doesn't sound promising.
Currents from all over the world converge in Engen's waters, so a lot of shipwrecks from distant seas end up there as their final resting place.
Uh-huh. Ah. So that's where the stories of ghost ships come from.
Boo. You guys have no imagination.
I'd rather they stay imaginary myself.
We should still be careful.
We'll be fine. Ghost ship, exorcist, whatever comes along. We'll be the ones to administer their last rites. Just one Therian to go. When I escaped, Ceres told me that Artorias could still be killed. That means she must have known everything. That Enominat is incomplete. How Therians work. But why did she betray Artorias? Why did she give me her strength? I know that, try as you might, some fires can never fully be extinguished. But what made you go so far as to feed yourself to me? Tell me, why did you do it, sis? Oh, what am I saying? Ceres was a Moloch. Just a Moloch. Just focus on what has to be done. Once the Therians are all together, I can end this. That's all that matters. That's all I need to think about.
Aw, come on! It's fine!
No, it's not. You have to do it right.
You're so mean, Medissa! If you keep telling me what to do, I'll hate you!
Fine. Hate me then. So long as you do what I say.
Fine! I love you, Medissa, and you don't even care!
What's going on here?
Eleanor! Medissa's being mean! She keeps telling me to dry my hair after my bath, but I don't wanna!
What? Is that all you're arguing about?
This is important. Just because she's a Therian doesn't mean she can't catch a cold.
But I won't! I won't catch a cold! I swear! I don't want to take Mom's yucky, awful medicine, so I'm not gonna get sick!
If you insist on being so stubborn, we can do this the hard way.
There's no need for everyone to get so worked up. Her hair's pretty much dry already, right?
Yeah, what she said!
I'm spoiling her, aren't I?
Seriously. Look, we don't even know what would happen if a Therian catches a cold, let alone how to treat it.
That's true.
But look, I get it. I know you feel responsible for her.
You mean what happened to her mother?
Yeah. Lafayette told me about it.
My, my. Look who's a little tattletale.
I'm sorry. But I thought Medissa should know. Just in case.
It's fine, I suppose. I should have told her myself.
Well, at least I understand everything now. It's all too tragic for words.
Yes. And the knowledge would not be something that a young child could possibly bear. I'm not planning on telling her.
That's probably your only option. But do you really think you can keep lying to her forever?
I have to. For her own sake.
For her, huh?
All right. I'll go with you on this.
You two are going through an awful lot of trouble for a selfish kid.
All kids are selfish. They're selfish. But that's what their families and their mothers should be there for. Don't you have any memories like that yourself?
Sorry, but I'd rather just keep them to myself.
Pish and piffle. Everybody and their issues, am I right?
Wondering if you'd let us put on a little comedy show. What do you say?
Sounds good to me. Just try and keep it low-key. I don't want to attract the Abbey's attention.
Ha! That's a tall order. Wherever we go, the boy and I have him rolling in the aisles.
The boy? Wait, you mean me?
I sure do. I'll play the straight man, you play the funny one.
Don't sweat it.
Even if you mess up, you'll be adorable. The audience will just lap it up. Did you memorize the script I wrote you?
Yeah, I think so.
Great! I knew you could do it! But if you merely follow the script and adhere to its every word, you won't be very funny. You need to ad-lib in your own style. For you, that's buttering up the audience and winning them over.
Ad-lib? I'm not sure I can do that.
I have faith in you, kiddo. You're gonna discover a part of you that you never knew existed. Just focus on finding ways to charm our audience.
Okay. I'll see what I can do.
Oh, right! Then let's get this show rolling! There. We're a boy and his witch, your partners in comedy today! Magikazam!
We're still new to the comedy business, but we'll do our best to give you a memorable show. I'm Fee, the cute one, and this blustering witch is...
Muggy Lou! Wait, who are you calling blustering?
Meow! Sorry, I just suddenly felt like doing an imitation.
An imitation? Like, of a cat?
Not just any cat, a nearby cat. Meow!
You're losing them. Time to go on our charm offensive. Roll with it, kiddo. Every slip-up is just a new opportunity in disguise.
See? It's supposed to be a pun on how cats sound and how near is pronounced. I didn't actually hear a nearby cat meow like that or anything.
He's explaining the joke? Are you going crazy, Lafayette? What good does explaining a bad joke do?
What, you told me to ad-lib to try and win our audience over, didn't you? I figured maybe if I explained it to them, they'd get the joke and find it funny.
Just stop. Even if they get the joke that way, it's just going to be sad.
I don't mind that. I'm not afraid of messing things up. I just want to make sure our audience feels valued.
No, no, you have the right idea, but...
I guess I should mention, Moggy Lou's the one who came up with the script. She just made me come and act it out.
I don't care if it made the audience happy, you just sold me out! I can't work with you like this. No way! I'd say we got a lot of ad-libbing into our routine today. How was the show?
Just say one thing. You need a better writer.
It wasn't me.
turtles! Boil oysters in the cloisters! Oh, got another letter for you, Aizen.
Okay.
Maybe it's from your sister this time.
You want to read it?
Me?
Please allow me. Now then.
Your cruelty knows no bounds. You bring deep sadness to a fair maiden's heart with each passing day. Repent, or else I'll be forced to intervene. This is your final warning.
And that's it.
Wow, this person sounds really mad.
Aizen, what did you go and do to make the fair maiden cry?
I don't know, but I could try a couple things on you.
Ooh, excuse me if I forget to be scared.
The letter mentions a fair maiden. Do you think it refers to your sister?
What?
Oh, you could be onto something. She must be lonely so far away from her brother.
It sounded like she's pretty fond of you.
Are you suggesting that Aizen's sister wrote these letters? I mean, they're certainly unusual, but...
My sister wouldn't write something like this.
Then maybe it's someone who's spending a lot of time around her. Like, oh, a man whose shoulder she cries on.
Damnation, Magilu! My sister doesn't have any guy clinging onto her! Do you know something I don't? Prove it! Bring him here right now!
Calm down, Aizen. No one's saying that.
But if you're really that worried, why don't you go see her? Have you not done that since you left?
I did go back once, a long time ago. But as soon as I showed up, a crowd started to gather. Overcome by malevolence, they turned into demons and attacked my sister then and there.
Do you think it's your fault that happened?
What do you think? I'd moved us to a safe place. Low in malevolence and high up a rugged mountainside.
So much for coincidence.
I haven't gone back to see her since.
Changing topics. I know I said these Nordals were a little off, but I think I'm starting to see that as part of their appeal.
Huh?
My point is, no matter how odd it might be, any gift could make a girl happy if it's given from the heart.
Sorry. You can't have one.
Thank you.
This must be Long Dao's dust. The ingredient Videl's Omega Elixir recipe calls for.
I can't believe you actually found it.
We have to go tell Videl. Maybe he's been able to translate the rest of the list.
Yeah.
Did you guys hear? The search party that went to the Laban Tunnel was wiped out by a demon.
Really? They were the ones out searching for Count Capilouse, weren't they?
You mean the one who managed to get kidnapped? Despite everyone else at his manor, servants and children alike getting killed? You'd think noblemen like that would have some decent exorcists among their personal guard.
Suppose he did. But I heard every blade there, sword and spear alike, was found chipped and cracked to hell.
What kind of demon could do that?
Who are the Capilouses?
They are one of the great noble lines, on par with Oscar's Dragonia family, and have served Midgand for generations.
People refer to them as the royal family's hidden dagger. Unlike me, you never hear good rumors about them. They say behind the royal family's glory lies blood and tears shed at the hand of the Capilouse family.
But those are just rumors. Although I do know that in recent times, the Count had stood against the rise of the Abbey. I couldn't care less about the whereabouts of some noble, but we should be careful of the demon that took out all those exorcists.
Yeah, it sounds like a worthy opponent.
Omega Elixir ingredients!
You found it! You really found it!
Yeah, it's proof your research is right.
Thanks! I've just managed to translate the description of the second ingredient. Here, take this and... Oh.
What's wrong? Your face is red.
Hey, you're burning up.
It's fine. I'm pretty much always running a fever.
That makes it even worse. We need to get you home so you can rest up.
But I'm still translating the recipe.
You heard me.
All right. She's scary. Is she your sister or something, Laffy said?
Well, it's kind of a long story.
Oh, okay. Well, you seem to have a pretty complicated life.
Do you think he's always that sick?
Wouldn't surprise me. I was weak when I was a kid, too.
He's probably been like this since he was born. That must be why his parents named him Videl. It means to live.
Huh. I never thought about that.
Luffy said is like that too. It means one who lives.
One who lives.
And he wants to be an explorer when he grows up. I feel sorry for him.
But if he drinks the Omega Elixir, I think he can get better. When he sets off on his adventures, will you let him aboard the Von Eldia, Aizen?
I suppose I could cut him a deal.
You'd charge him?
I'm a pirate, kid. Comes with the territory. But I promise you, I won't charge him too much.
I suppose that'll have to do.
One who lives. I did not know that Lafayette's name had meaning behind it.
Didn't mean much in the end. I poured my soul into getting him through. But he's still dead all the same. Hope. What a waste.
You really think it was pointless?
What else am I supposed to think? It won't bring him back.
We're coming up on Lionel Island.
So much for the ghost ships.
Should we expect another welcome party waiting for us again?
No. I had the Bloodwings spread a rumor that we were raiding an Abbey compound far, far from here.
As far as plans go, that's better than nothing.
All this cloak and dagger. Give me a good old frontal assault any day.
First mate, sir. There's a ship drifting ahead of us.
A ghost ship?
It's an Abbey ship. Their flag. It's a distress signal.
Understood. Commence approach.
Are you actually going to help an enemy ship?
A ship signaling distress has neither allies nor enemies. That's a code all seafarers abide by.
It's an obvious trap.
Not even pirates would use a distress signal for a surprise attack. Of course, after we rescue a ship, we still strip them of everything they've got.
Anyway, if it's a trap, we'll kill everyone on board. Simple.
A waste of time, if you ask me.
Is this... the Corsair Scourge?
Benwick, do we still have any Salatoma left?
Yes, sir. If this is their full crew, we should have enough on board to treat them.
Now that you mention it, don't Abbey ships usually have a bigger crew?
These were all who were aboard when I hijacked the ship and made them set sail.
Teresa!
I knew I was being reckless, but I never expected we'd run afoul of the Corsair Scourge. But you know, I'm glad we did. Since it brought me to you.
You seriously plan to fight in that condition?
No, no. I know you've won this one. Use me as you will.
Use you?
Don't bother asking. It's a trap.
Lionel Island is where you'll find Dees. Hetherian. My brother Oscar is guarding over it.
We can handle him just fine.
You should know that Oscar's acquired a powerful new art. Its formula developed by Lord Melchior. The art heightens a Moloch's power far beyond its normal limits. The effect is incredible. Normal arts don't even compare. Even were you to win, you wouldn't come away unscathed.
Why are you telling us this?
The art is still untested and imperfect. There's no guarantee its caster will survive the effects. I don't want anything to happen to Oscar. If I'm your hostage, Oscar won't move against you. This will afford you a window to snatch the Therian and make your escape.
You're willing to betray the Abbey?
There's nothing in this world that could ever replace Oscar. I know you can't trust me, so don't give me your medicine. I'll place my life in your hands. Just save Oscar.
Lady Teresa!
If true, this information will be of use to us. For now, let's bring her aboard and give her the medicine.
So, you're going to believe her story?
An art that boosts a Moloch's power far beyond its normal limits. Sounds like we might be in for a real fight.
And she said that Melchior developed it, too.
Maybe this explains why he was so intent on acquiring that Siegfried relic.
If this is all true, a frontal assault might not be the best idea.
But why do you think Teresa is willing to go so far to protect Oscar?
Oscar is the second son of the Dragonia family. Aristocrats with ancestral ties to the Asgard royal lineage. From what I understand, he was sent to the Abbey in the hopes of strengthening his family's ties to the group.
For the good of the bloodline. Happens all the time.
Teresa followed him to the Abbey, where she's been his constant savior, even if she's kept it from him.
So she's another noble too. Could have had an easy life if she'd just kept in her place.
No, Teresa was conceived, outside of formal matrimony. And her mother was not of what you'd call high standing.
It happens more often than you might think. My mother died, and my father's wife never cared for me. So I merely served the Dragonia family as a maid. Those were dark, lonely times for me. But Oscar... Oscar was the only one who called me his sister, and embraced me as family. Does a sister need any other reason to want to save her brother?
So you're back on your feet.
My sincere thanks for the medicine.
I can't use you as a hostage if you're dead. Where's the Therian?
Ahead through the Baird Marsh are the ruins of an ancient kingdom. There you'll find the Earth Pulse Point, along with Oscar.
What happened to number one?
Lord Artorias took number one away from me. As it stands, I'm without the powers of an exorcist. As such, whether I live or die is for you people to decide. Once Oscar is safe, you can do whatever you like to me.
We'll do as you wish. All of it. I know you know this, Fee, but don't let your guard down for one second.
I won't.
Scout ship settings.
I'll send a Sylph-Jay if anything comes up here. Have a safe trip.
Thanks.
Still, why would the Abbey build anything all the way out here?
Teresa, what do you know?
This island may be uninhabited now, but judging from the ruins, we can tell that civilization has flourished and fallen here many times. This island lies at a focal point of air and sea currents, as well as the flow of the Earth Pulse. That means that malevolence gathers here too.
Is that why civilization has risen and fallen here before?
It is. Furthermore, the malevolence of those long-dead people still lingers here, lost and unfading.
Even after so long?
The more they prospered, the greater the loss of life.
Normally, this sort of thing could not be ignored. The malevolence here should have been dealt with in haste,
But because the Abbey is scheming to resurrect Enominat, there's no way they'd want to waste such a bounty. Bursting with malevolent juiciness, and no meddlesome people around to cause trouble. There couldn't be a more perfect spot.
If there's one place they'd put Etherion, it's here.
This is an Abbey encampment. No one's stationed here now, but it's well maintained.
From what I could gather, it will be approximately 10 days before the next patrol stops by.
That's more than enough time to find the Therian and get it off the Earth Pulse.
We can rest here, too. No need to rush things. We'll find the Therian, but let's do it right.
Thank you.